What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and you just saw a quick unboxing on the ThinkCentre M90n Nano from Lenovo, and what comes inside the box. So let's start with the safety and warranty guide, right? We have the setup guide right here. We have three AA batteries. Two batteries go for the keyboard, which is a wireless keyboard, and the other extra AA battery goes for the wireless mouse, which this is the mouse that actually comes with the device. We open it up, you will see the transmitter right there. Awesome. And then you have the wireless keyboard. We also have a Type-C to HDMI adapter. This is pretty cool. We have a wireless antenna. I'm gonna put this guy right here because we're going to hook it up pretty soon to the device. We have your power cord, and then you have your power adapter, which is actually 65 watts. I'm gonna take the power cord and hook it up to the power adapter. Bam, I'm gonna put this to the side because we are going to plug this guy up very soon. And then finally, we have the beautiful ThinkCentre M90n Nano from Lenovo. This guy is extremely light, weighing around 1.0 pounds with a thickness of 0.95 inches. Now, the measurement of the device going this way is around 7 inches by 3.5 inches. Which is a nice size. So I'm actually gonna take the wireless antenna and I'm gonna hook it up right here in the back. Awesome. Now the M90n-1 has a lot of ports and features. You have a couple of ports on the back and the front. So let's go over some of the ports on the back side. So we have our power adapter port, a display port, one 3.1 USB port, a Type-C port, an additional 3.1 USB port. You have your RJ45 port, and last but not least, you have your wireless antenna port. Now, on the front side, we have the following. We have a power button. We have a Type-C. We have two 3.1 USB ports. And then last but not least, our combo audio jack. Okay, so let's plug this guy up, power it on, and configure it to build our Jenkins server. Awesome. All right, so I got the M90n-1 hooked up with keyboard and mouse. I'm actually using wired. I'm taking advantage of the two 3.1 USB at the back of the device. I'm definitely taking advantage of the Type-C to HDMI adapter, hooked it up to HDMI display, and then we have the power, and definitely I'm taking advantage of the wireless connection. Awesome. So the power button is located right here in the front, so we are going to press it to turn it on. Beautiful. All right, so before we go over some of the specifications on the M90n-1 from Lenovo, let's talk about the speaker, because I was super surprised of the audio on this little guy. I thought I actually had to hook up external speakers, but that wasn't the case. The M90n-1 actually has speakers at the very bottom, and the loudest that I got on the audio was around 101.1 decibels. That's extremely loud. All right, so let's go over some of the specifications on the M90n-1 from Lenovo. As you can see on my desktop, I have a lot of programs that I installed. I actually installed VMware Workstation, DaVinci Resolve. I actually have Audition, Premiere, Photoshop, Illustrator. This machine is a monster. But the only thing I do not like about the machine, which we will go over pretty soon, I'm not going to spoil it right now, but let's go over the specifications. So if I right-click on the taskbar, let's go to Task Manager. Let's open Task Manager up a little bit. Let's go to Performance. Let's right-click on the CPU. Let's change the graph to a logical processor. And this machine is actually running an Intel Core i5-8265U with a clock speed of 1.60 gigahertz. Now, you can actually get it configured with i7, and I would recommend getting it to i7. Spend that extra money on this device. It actually has one socket, four cores, eight logical processors, memory. This machine only has 8 gigs. Now, this is where I actually have to tell you my con. 8 gigs or 16 gigs, that's the highest that you could get this machine. That's the only bad thing about this machine. The highest that you could get in memory is only 16 gigs. You can't physically open this guy up and upgrade the memory. Now, for storage, this one actually has 512 gigs. And for the graphics card, it's running an Intel Ultra HD Graphics 620. Now, this little guy is a powerhouse. It's jam-packed with so much power that I was able to do a lot of video editing, 4K editing with Premiere. I was able to edit within Audition. I was even able to do a little bit of coloring within DaVinci Resolve. One cool thing is I was able to run VMware Workstation with no problem. Pretty soon we are going to go over how to configure a Jenkins server using this device, because that's what I use and I was super happy. So I actually built macOS 10.16, which is the latest OS. I'm going to power this guy on and I was able to run this. I was able to run my Jenkins server, which I'm going to power this guy on as well. This little guy is so powerful. Now for heating, I did notice heating around here, but it's not that bad. Average of heat was around 87 degrees around here in the body. If you measure the temperature around the vents, which are vents right here on the side and the back and the bottom, I got a reading around 94 degrees, which is not that bad. Okay, so I actually have my Jenkins server up and running. I'm gonna log into this machine right now. I actually have my macOS 11, which is loading up. I'm gonna let the macOS load up, and then we are going to get into configuring this machine to run Jenkins. All right, so let's get started on building a Jenkins server on the ThinkCentre M90n-1 from Lenovo. I actually have the server that's running Jenkins that I built the server on, and I'm using VMware Workstation. And it's running flawless. So if I open up a browser and I go inside the IP address of this particular machine, right? That's Jenkins. And I want to show you guys that if I open up a terminal, let's go to system, qterminal. I'm going to run a if config. The IP address is 192.168.211.129, which is the same right here in the browser. Cool. And I'm going to log into this guy right now. Created an account, BTNHD. I already have a repository already synced up, which is my GitHub repository. Beautiful workspace. Awesome. Look at that. I'm actually using Ubuntu as my primary operating system, version 20.04. I'm going to open up my Windows terminal because I am going to PuTTY inside this virtual machine to configure it, right? Got to do it the geeky way. So I PuTTY'd in. I'm inside BTNHD-Jenkins, which is the virtual machine. And the first command that I'm going to do is sudo app updates. I'm going to update that virtual machine. And then the next thing that we need to do is find if we have openjdk. I'm going to do a sudo app search openjdk, which is Java. Then I'm going to run the following command of sudo app install to install version 8 of Java within this machine. Hit enter. Then I'm going to run a command of Java version. Now the next command that we are going to run is sudo add app repository universe. I think when I read the article within the Jenkins site of how to configure this, it wanted you to run this. It looks like I already have that component already enabled within the server, so I'm good to go. The next command that we need to run is the following. This will actually pull the application directly to your machine as well as get a key. So once you hit enter, it's going to give you okay. Then we need to run the following to configure our server. Once you hit enter, boom. Then the next thing that we need to do is run a sudo apt-get update. Once you do that, it is time to actually install Jenkins on the server. So we are going to run a sudo apt-get install Jenkins, hit enter, hit yes here. The next thing that we need to do is start Jenkins as a service. So we are going to run a sudo systemctl status Jenkins. We need to enable the firewall within our Linux system. So we are going to run a sudo ufw enable. And the next command that we need to run is we are going to allow 8080 because that is the port that Jenkins use. So we are going to do a sudo ufw allow 8080. Now we need to continue the configuration of the Jenkins server. So open up your favorite browser and enter the IP address of the server with the port of 8080, hit enter, and you're going to get this. Now, automatically, Jenkins is locked, so we need to go into that particular location to retrieve the admin password. So go back inside your server, and we're going to do a sudo cat that location, hit enter, and it's going to give you that long password. So make sure you copy it, go back inside the site, paste it, and hit continue. And then you have two options. I'm going to do install suggested plugins. So click on that. It's going to start processing. It's going to change all green. Once it's green, it's going to take you here to create your first admin user. So provide a username, password, confirm the password, give it a full name, and give it an email address, and then click on save and continue. Then it gives you the Jenkins URL. This is the URL that you need to enter to log into the server and make modifications. So I'm going to click on save and finish, and then bam, Jenkins is ready to use. So click on start using Jenkins, and then it takes you here. Now the first thing that we need to do is create a new item. So click on new item, it takes you here. You're going to provide it a name and pick freestyle project, and then click OK. And we need to go inside source code management and pick Git. And from here, enter your repository URL. And then once you enter your repository URL, we need to go to the build triggers tab and then enter your schedule. I want this to sync every minute, but again, it's up to you. Once you do all that, click on save. Once you click on save, it takes you back here and you're going to see that you have your new repository. If you click on the repository, it's going to show you everything that's inside your GitHub repository. Awesome. All right, so let's conclude our review on the ThinkCentre M90n-1 from Lenovo. We just built a Jenkins server on it using VMware Workstation. I actually had macOS 11 on it. I had DaVinci, Resolve, Premiere. I did everything on this machine, and it's awesome. This little guy is definitely one of those things that you could use for like a server. It does have two Type-C ports that you can actually hook up a storage device and like wipe clean the Windows operating system and install ESXi and create a bunch of virtual machines on this guy. Now, the only thing I do not like about this machine is the limitation of memory. You can only get it configured with 8 gigs or 16. It'd have been awesome if maybe 32, 64. Now, for pricing, retail price is around $399. And the highest point on this guy is only $655. For a processor, i7, I would definitely get this guy i7, max out the memory, and max out the storage device, which actually could go up to 1 terabyte. For external monitors, you get 2 Type-C monitors and a display. They do provide a Type-C to HDMI adapter, which I was actually using. Really small. It doesn't really overheat, but you can actually put it inside a LAN room, you know, and it will keep it nice and cool. Overall, great, great device, great price. The only thing I do not like about it is the limitation of memory. And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this review on the ThinkCentre M90n-1 from Lenovo. Make sure to hit that like button. Also, do not forget about punch, elbow, and smashing that subscribe button to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.